Today I wanted to talk to you about the second handheld system put out by Sega in North America, the Sega Nomad. What, you've never heard of the Sega Nomad? Released in 1995, the Nomad was basically a portable Genesis. Less than a year later, it was discontinued and sold at a discount price. So, what was this system and why did it fail? Alright, let's take a look at the Nomad. First thing I want to comment on is the actual name of the system. I really like it. The term Nomad means a wanderer, or someone who doesn't stay in one place. It's actually a very fitting name for a handheld system. Unfortunately, you'll probably be sitting in one place while playing this thing. An AV out. Yeah. You can hook up the Nomad to your TV, essentially making it a Genesis with the Nomad acting as your controller. It uses the same power adapter and AV cables as the Genesis Model 2. And even an extra controller port. That's right, you and a friend can play on the Nomad. It'll take any controller the Genesis can. Even the arcade stick.
Yeah, you can't have three players playing the Mega Drive at the same time. Only two people could play it.
The Nomad can play all Genesis titles and even some Mega Drive games, as long as they aren't region locked. However, it is not compatible with the power-based converter, Sega CD, or the Sega 32X. The Genesis 3? What? The Genesis 3, model number MK1461. Let's go over the system itself. First of all, it's tiny and weighs practically nothing. Maybe even too light. Seriously, if you jerk your controller around at all, this thing might come flying off the shelf.